Great. It is truly a blessing to be back together in one body in Christ Jesus, because he is so good all of the time. And all of the time, God is good. I'm so glad I learned to acknowledge that, because at one point in my life, I just knew I was existing, doing what I thought I wanted to do, doing what I thought I was big enough to do, and doing a whole lot I didn't have the sense to understand I shouldn't have been. But I thank God he looked beyond my faults to see my very needs. That's why I have to thank him when I look at this world today. I have to thank him for what he brought me from. Because in some situations, I see myself in some people where I used to be. But then when I think about where he brought me from, how he picked me up and he turned me around. And in doing that, he turned my whole life around. I am happy this day that Lord has made. And guess what? I am going to rejoice. Again, I say, I am going to rejoice and be glad. So glad. The O's just run out when I say that, because don't nobody know how far the Lord have brought each and every one of us but ourselves. So therefore, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day.
This is the day
that the Lord has made.
That the Lord has made.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice
and be glad in it.
And be glad in it. For he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
This is the day.
This is the day
that the Lord has made. I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
And be glad in it.
And be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it.
This is the day.
The day
that the Lord. Another glorious and blessed day. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart Be acceptable in your sight, O Lord God, my Creator and my Redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. And the entire body of Christ said, amen. Amen. Glory be to God our Father. And at this moment, I'm going to have you to just take a seat, and we are going to go into our lesson plan for this series, What Made Them to Be Pricked in Their Heart. Reading from Acts, the second chapter, if you will find our text words. So let us remember that if we are going to rejoice in the Lord, then we must be glad that the Lord gave us another opportunity. Amen. Amen. If you're not glad about Jesus, you're in a rough spot. Amen. A very rough spot. So, looking at verses 41 and 42, and we need to really understand how glad we should be for following up on what we claim to be a very crucial or important part of our livelihood. Looking at verses 41 and 42, Acts the second chapter, then they that gladly received his word were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread and in prayer. That's why we ask the question, what made them to be pricked in their heart? Amen? Because something dramatic have to happen for your heart to be touched. You see, I want you to know why we are on this series so long. Anybody just can't touch your heart. Anybody can't touch your heart in the way God can touch your heart. And we thank the Lord this morning for your presence, for sitting in on these series of messages, because God wants our hearts to be right with him. Thank you, social media, for tuning in wherever you are. Because God wants hearts that are willing to take whatever is necessary to become a true bona fide follower of him. See, we all have the privilege or opportunity to go to church when we want to go to whatever church we want to go to, and to follow whatever we want to follow. God gives us these options, but we ought to sincerely take them as not just an option, but a fact that God gave us a way out of any situation or circumstance that we may fall in. And it doesn't matter what age bracket you're in, young or old, amen. He just wants us to understand there is a way out of the world into his kingdom. Amen, because I'm on my way out of here. Amen, I'm on my way to glory land. And I don't mind nobody knowing in which direction I'm going. I'm going up. Amen. I'm not going down. I've been down. Amen. He brought me up out of the mess. Now I'm on my way up to a glory land. Amen. Can I get somebody? Our God is just so good. And we must understand that he doesn't give us life to inhale and exhale how we just want to do it. But he gives us life to understand how we should go about doing it. Amen. We really must know how I should this and how I should that in order to be number one, pleasing to God. And I have noted in my text, in my message here, that some characteristics of a true follower and a prick heart from this message, what made them to be pricked in their heart. The Lord gave me some characteristics of a true follower and a pricked heart. Now, somebody might say, I don't know when my heart has been pricked. Well, in a sense of speaking, that might not be necessary. It's because we just need to know that a life-changing experience hit us one day and we became converted from what we were to who we are. And that is a child who gladly receives the word. See, if you are not receiving the word with a happy heart, you are grieving the word. And my Bible teaches me my God is not a grievous God. He is a loving God. And everything he gives us, he wants us to love it. Somebody said, I can't love tribulations. You might not can love tribulations, but tribulations gonna come anyway. So you might as well start loving the one who gives tribulation. And I grant you, your trials and your tribulations will become stepping stones. He'll teach you how to walk over every bump in the road. He'll teach you how to endure every trying time. Because my Bible said, all things work together for good for those who love the Lord and call according to his purpose. It is not my purpose, it's God's purpose that I'm standing here this morning, that the doctor declared I don't need an operation. It is God's purpose that he told me to tell you, if you haven't accepted him, you need to step in line right now. Amen. You need to stop what you're doing right now in your mind. You see, I can't get in your mind, and I'm so glad I can't. Because sometimes I don't know what this mind I have. But I know God can step in right now and he can change everything in your life. You even thought that he didn't want. He can change it and he'll give you a new light. He'll give you a new light and a new life. He just won't bring you out of the darkness, but he'll give you a light to see the life he told you to live. Now, you can't see it until you see the light of Jesus. Go on to your doctor, your counselor, or supervisor. I'm not telling you not to go be advised on whatever you need to be advised on. But I'm telling you that God is the best advisor. He is the best advisor. He is the best supporter. He is the best way out of any situation you could ever face. David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. The world is full of evil today. But don't you fool yourself. David also said, I would have fainted if I had not looked again and saw the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. There are some good things going on. We need to focus on the good thing more than the bad. So some characteristics of a true follower and a pricked heart, we find, number one, the inward heart is the inward proof. Found in John 5, 1 and 10, he said, whosoever believeth that Jesus is the one that loveth him, he that whosoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. And everyone that loveth him, that begat, loveth him also that is begotten of him. My God, my God. By this is what he wants you to know. By this, we know that we love the children of God. When we love God and keep his commandment. Isn't God good? I say, isn't he good? Isn't he good all the time? Because it is a fact that you can be saved and know you've been saved. Some people say, how do I know I've been saved? Well, number one, he said, believe that Jesus Christ died for all of our sins. It's simply belief. It's no arithmetic or mathematics. It's no theological degree or whatever you might need to help you understand that. Just read your Bible. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. Some people think they got to do this or do that. He said, whosoever believe. I just need to drive that to you, because some people are thinking they got to do something. You don't have to do but one thing, and that's believe that Jesus is the Christ. Man, that 10th verse said, and he that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in him. He that believeth not God hath made him a liar. It's a dangerous thing to tell God you weren't made right. You was made to be like, and you was made to be like, and you was made to be like. It's a dangerous thing to tell God that he's a liar. That's the worst thing that you could ever do, to tell God how he didn't make you. He made you how he wants you. He gave you a mind to know that only he could make you. If he could make a monkey, he ought to be able to make a man. I don't believe in evolution in that aspect. I know my God. I know my God wonderfully made me. I might not look so wonderful to you. My face might not be so beautiful to you. My walk and my talk might not sound like you want it. But I'm so glad this morning. I can tell my God. I can tell my God. I don't care how you look at me, take care of my enemy. And I look so good to God, he'll take care of it. Amen. God wants some looking good folk. Amen. I'm not talking about the outside. I'm talking about the inward proof. Amen. Some people can tell you they're saved, but they can't give you no proof. Yeah, sometimes they try to give you a proof and you come to find out it's a lie. Ooh, I don't want nobody to find that out about me. I want the proof to stand. Somebody wrote a song, said, let the life that I live speak for me. I'm glad I don't have to run around hollering, I'm a Christian. I'm a Christian. My God know who I am. That's enough for me. Quit being ashamed to know God know you. Love God and keep his commandments. I wish I could preach like I would. I said love God and keep his commandments. And if you keep God's commandments, you will know in your heart to love your brother, even if he doesn't love you. Those who say all kind of ugly stuff, I still love you. Oh my God, he's a good God. Inward proof. Because he believeth not the record that God gave of his son. And this is the record, that God hath even to us eternal life, that this life is his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Now, what theologian you need to explain that to you? I just read it. If you don't have the Son, you don't have life. Jesus tried to make it as plain as he could through speaking through parables, and somebody still walked away shaking their head saying, he talking about he the bread of life. No, and then when Jesus really messed up and he said, you must eat of my flesh, my God, I wish I had, and you must drink the blood of my body. Jesus, 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 oh my Jesus, how can I do that? Now Jesus said, I must believe that his death and that his burial and his resurrection is the bread and the life, is the water, amen, of life. The blood is the cleanser. It's a deep cleansing agent. If you are not sprinkled with the blood, if you are not washed in the water of Jesus Christ, you don't have Christ. If you can't declare Christ in public, if you have to hide like Nicodemus did at midnight, you must understand that you got to be, you must be born again. Amen, 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 amen. Number two, 1 John 4 and 7, give us the outgoing proof. 1 John 4 and 7, give us the outgoing proof. You know, it's one thing to have something on the inside, but what's on the inside must come to the outside. Jesus said it's not what comes inside of the man, but it's what comes out of the man, what makes him clean. Don't you know that what you eat makes a difference in your physique or your body? What you drink makes a difference. Amen. I used to celebrate Christmas and Thanksgiving, getting drunk and having parties. I used to think that that was the way you celebrate. Where's the party? Party gonna be at the big house tonight. It's a big white house. Big white house we used to go to on Fridays and Saturday night. The people owned this big white pretty house. And we said, we're going to the big white house tonight. I knew what was going on in the big white house. There's going to be some partying going on. Amen. Christmas holidays, I wake up and didn't know how I got home. I found my necktie down the hallway, my one shoe in my room and one shoe down the hallway. Didn't know how I got to the house. I knew I got home. Amen. And nobody, I found out that nobody bring me through that stuff but God. Didn't nobody bring me through that stuff but God. The more I drink, the drunker I got. Sometimes I didn't even know I was driving. One night I woke up in a ditch, driving on the highway, 75 miles an hour. The Lord woke me up, and I found out I was in the ditch with all them weeds was in front of me. I thought I was a weed cutter. The Lord told me to hit that steering wheel and come out of that ditch. I came on out that ditch that night. I still didn't pray right, though. I still kept getting in ditches. And one day I got in a ditch and I couldn't come out. And I called my mama and my mama couldn't help me. I called my daddy and my daddy couldn't help me. Oh, church, you gonna help me? I called my friends and my friends couldn't help me. Matter of fact, some of them was locked up, too. But I want you to know you can't call nobody. You ought to be able to call on God, because God will make a way out of no way. I don't care who you are and where you come from. God will pick you up, and he'll turn you around. And he'll let you know that can't nobody do you like I can. Can I get somebody? That's the reason why I have to tell a dying world, and sometimes in some cases a sick world, because the world is sick and the land is becoming so wicked. But my God is still on his throne. My God is still the ruler of all rulers. Come or go, my God is still ruling. Don't you feel him right now? You ought to feel him when you hold your hands up. You ought to feel the power of the Spirit of God in your hand. You ought to feel him when you sit down at your supper table. You ought to know that God is the one who put the food on the table. Can I get a witness? You ought to know that God is getting the glory out of everything you do. You might have the talent to run, jump, speak, or whatever, but you ought to say, God, I thank you for putting the words in my mouth. God, I thank you for putting the food on my table. Somebody can walk out of here and get in the best looking car, but you ought to know that God is the one who gave me this automobile. And you know what? I'm going to tell God I thank him. I don't care how you praise me, because I dress up and look good, I'm going to say, God gave me this dress code. Now I see. I once was blind, but now I see the glory of the Lord. Can't you see his glory working through the progress? Can't you see his glory in this little old building? This is nothing but a drop in the bucket. What God can do for you. Don't you know my God sits high and he looks down low? That's why I have to call on him. I have to call on him not every once in a while, but I have to call on him all day long. Because the Lord, I said, Lord, I don't know, but you know what I'm trying to do. You see, I have activities that I want to do, but God have an activity he told me to do, and I'm going to do it until the day I die. He said, Lord Jones, I want you to go into the world, and I want you to preach my word. And I just don't want you to preach. I want you to live my word. Do not preach one thing and do another. But you tell my children, follow me as I follow Christ Jesus. I don't know about you, but I'm walking and I'm talking with my Lord. Because my Lord, he picked me up one day when I was doing my thing. I was doing it my way. It was my way or no way. But my God stepped in right on time. Could have been dead, buried in my grave. But my God stepped in right on time. And I'm glad he stepped in to my heart. I heard him knocking at my door. I kept ignoring that knock and said it wasn't nobody until one day he taught me how to fall down. And when I fell down, I couldn't get up. And I said, Lord, help me. He said, Lord, what are you doing? I said, Lord, help me. I called my mother, and my mother couldn't help me. I called my father, and my father couldn't help me. I called my sister, and my sister couldn't help me. I called my brother, and my brother couldn't help me. And one day, my mother said, I'll call a lawyer and see can he help you. My mother called a lawyer, but my lawyer couldn't help me. I'm so glad I heard the voice of Jesus said, ye that labor and are heavy laden, come unto me
and I will give you rest. Now I'm glad I'm walking and I'm resting in the Lord. When you see my hands up, I'm not just waving at you. I'm giving God a wave offering because it brought me not just from a mighty long way, but it brought me from all. He 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 brought me from all the way. Did he bring you? Did he bring you? Did he have anything to do with you? You ought to wave you. Did he say yes? You ought to say yes. Did he say Lord? You ought to say Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Right now, Lord. Not tomorrow. Right now. My God. My God. My God. He's a good God. He's a good God. How can you not serve a good God? How can you not want to lay down your life for a good God? For a precious God? For a mighty God? Oh, what a mighty, 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 mighty. Are you free this morning? If you're not free, don't raise your hand if you're not free. But are you free this morning? If you're not free, don't raise your hand. But if you're free this morning, give him a wave off. I am a free. Praise the Lord, I'm free. I've been saved and sanctified with the Lord on my side. My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. One more time. Yeah. I am a free. Praise the Lord. I'm I've been saved and sanctified with the Lord on my side. My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. I am a saved. Praise the Lord, I'm saved. I've been saved and sanctified with the Lord on my side. My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm saved. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm saved. Everybody now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm saved. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul, for bringing me out of the dirt to the mountaintop, out of the mess to the mercy, out of the grief to the courageousness. Thank you for being my yoke. Thank you for being so easy to incline. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to reach out to those who are in need of dropping their water pot or weapon to run and say, come and see a man who has told me all things. Thank you, Lord, for showing us all things are possible with God. thank you for those who are walking down the aisle to give their heart to you and their hand to the preacher. Thank you, Father, for those who are declaring, I'm not going that way any longer. Now I see Jesus for who he is. Thank you, Lord, for letting me see Jesus for who he is. In the glorious name, in the glorious and loving name, amen and amen. Give God all the praise. 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 Because it's prayer time. It's prayer time. Stay in prayer. Much prayer equals much faith. No prayer, little faith. We must not cease to pray to give God the glory. For he brought us from January to November, even before we realized it was a January, even before we understood what November would be. He is the one who brought us. He is the one who looked out for us. He is the one who checked on us. He is the one who made us out of the dust of the earth and gave us a mind and a soul to return to him. And now, Lord, we're going to ask those who want to be specially prayed for to raise their hands by social media. Just raise your hand where you are. Right here in our midst, just raise your hand right where you are. Just give God your heart right where you are. If there's anything in your heart you know not should be there, just tell God. Just plead with God. Just come to God in Christian and in a contrite way. Come to God in a way that you never came to him before and said, God, please take this stuff from my heart because my heart is vexed and I want my heart to be in glory for you. Lord, release my heart. Break the chains right now, Lord, because I know you can. And I know you will, Lord. If you don't break them, Lord, they'll never get broken. But somebody said I could never be, Lord. But I know you know me. I know you know I can be better than what I am. Lord, I need you right now. I need you to touch me, Lord, in a way. Lord, if it's somebody in my family, Lord, touch them, Lord. Somebody in my house, in my home. Lord, a friend, Lord, that I love so much. Lord, touch them. Because, Lord, I can't touch them like you can touch them, but you can, Lord. You can take away better than I can take away, Lord. You can give better than I can give, Lord. And I'm pleading right now, Lord, whatever it is, let it be your will. Because your will must be done, Lord. And I want your will to be done on earth as it is in heaven, Lord. Because your will, Lord, is being neglected on so many occasions. But right now, Lord, we want those who are giving the devil praise to stop for a moment and give you praise and give you honor and give you the respect that you deserve in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask all these blessings. Amen. Give God some praise. Give God. You know it's a blessing to give him praise. It's a blessing. I hope we didn't hold you too long, but it's a blessing. When God got his hold on you. This time now we're going to call for Minister Dickey to come to lift our tithes and our offering.
scripture. 1 Corinthians 13:1-8. Do I speak with tongues of men and of angels? Have not charity, I become a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And do I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge? And do I have all faith so that I can remove mountains? Have not charity, I am nothing. Do I bestow all my goods to feed the poor? And do I give my body to be burned? Have not charity, it profit me nothing. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity imitateth not, charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up, does not behave itself unseemly, seeketh no not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hope at all things, endure it. Charity never fail, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away.
To do what?
To reap what I have sown.
You say, this is my season
for grace.
For what else?
For favor.
This is my season
to reap what I have sown.
Listen, everything is working together for my good. Say, church, everything.
We're going to ask one of the ushers off the blessed offering.